Good morning, good evening, good afternoon. My name is Outi Honkatukia. I'm the Chief Negotiator for Climate Change for Finland and also the UNFCCC focal point. And it is indeed my pleasure to present the multilateral assessment for Finland. Now, starting with the greenhouse gas emissions and looking at the trends from 1990 to 2019, we can see a clear downward trend in emissions. Energy sector is still the largest emission source, but especially there, the emission reductions have been significant. Looking at the trend again from 1990 to 2019, without the LULUCF, and also comparing those emissions with those in 1990 and also 2018 to 2019, we can see that there's been a significant 26% emission reduction from the 1990 levels. This corresponds to 18.4 million tons of CO2 equivalents. The change from 2018 to 2019 is also significant. Total emissions, excluding the LULUCF, reduced by 6%. There, the energy sector was the greatest contributor to this emission reduction, followed by industrial processes and other product use and waste management. There was a slight increase in the emissions from agriculture. Examples of our key policies and measures include the EU's emission trading scheme, which is really responsible for reducing emissions in the energy production and industry sectors. We also have various schemes to promote renewable energy. These include premium schemes, investment subsidies, and the blending obligation for biofuels in the transport sector. We have various energy efficiency measures such as energy audits, energy efficiency agreements, and minimum standards for new buildings, and so on. We are implementing the landfill directive and national legislation and strategies aimed at reducing the amount of waste generated and minimizing the amount of waste disposed at landfills. We also have stringent F-gas regulations in place. Turning now to the with measures projection, there we first of all in this figure you can see the latest greenhouse gas emission inventory data and then the with measures projection up to 2030. And indeed, the projection says that the significant emission reductions will continue. The EU legislation is very important for Finland's targets, climate and energy targets, and there our national targets under the EU legislation are much more stringent than those of the EU average. So, for example, when the looking at the EU ETS sector, obviously it's an EU-wide target of minus 21%, but for the non-ETS emissions, where the EU-wide target is 10%, the target for Finland is 16%. For renewable energy on final consumption, our target is 38% compared with the EU average of 20, or the EU-wide target of 20. And for biofuels in transport, our target is 20% compared with the EU-wide target of 10%. Now, looking at Finland's annual emission allocations under the effort sharing decision, so you can see the emission allocation, which is the dark red line with a bit of very sort of strong downward trend. And you can also see our projection is estimated for 2020, which is well below the emission allocation. Now, this estimate for 2020 takes into account the unusually warm weather in winter 2019-2020. And also the impact of the coronavirus on the consumption of transport fuels, both also contributing to this downward trend in the emissions. Now, I'd like to say a few words about our long-term emission reduction targets. The government is working to ensure that Finland is carbon neutral by 2035 and carbon negative soon after that. We are accelerating emission reduction measures and strengthening carbon sinks. Additional measures for achieving carbon neutrality are proposed in the new energy and climate strategy, the medium-term climate change policy plan, and the climate program for the land use sector. These documents Work on this document is underway and the documents will be completed next year in 2021. Finland's long-term target under the National Climate Change Act states that at least 80% emission reductions by 2050 compared to the 1990 level. Now, this act is currently under review, and indeed, like much of the focus of the review is on the 2050 target, which then has to be in line with our national ambitious carbon neutrality target of being neutral by 2035. Finland is committed to EU's climate neutrality target by 2050, and we support raising EU's 2030 emission reduction target to at least minus 55% from the current level of at least 40%. Few words on the successes and challenges in implementing climate change policies. Finland's energy sector emissions per capita are higher in the EU on average due to our cold climate, energy-intensive industry structure, and the low population density, which results to long travelling, commuting, and transport distances. Our energy sector emissions have been reducing significantly since 1990, though at the same time our energy consumption has increased. So there's an absolute decoupling there with emissions in the energy sector. The share of renewables has increased since 1990. It was 41.2% in 2018, and the use of fossil fuels has decreased. Emissions from waste sector have decreased by 63% since 1990. Here again, the waste legislation plays a key role, and it has significantly reduced landfilling of waste. Just to continue on the successes and challenges in implementing climate change policies, emissions in the transport sector were almost 6% lower in 2019 than in 1990. These positive developments seen in the recent years include the number of electric and gas-fueled cars. They've increased steadily, and this trend is expected to continue. Distribution obligation of biofuels has reduced emissions from transport. The blending obligation will gradually increase, which will further reduce emissions in coming years. Emissions from agriculture sector are hard to abate. I think this is a common thing for most parties in the multilateral assessment. Emissions in 2018 were 12% lower than in 1990, but they have remained almost constant in 2005-2019. The amount of synthetic fertilizers used has decreased by 40% from 1990 to 2018 and is the most important factor in the reduced emissions in this sector. And now getting towards the end of my presentation on the multilateral assessment of Finland. Still have two slides to go. I'll be fairly brief on them, but do want to share with you the success stories for renewable energy. So here's a slide showing the historic development and the width measures projection for renewable energy. And you can see the trend from 1990 to, first of all, to the 2020, and then also to 2030. And as you can see, it is indeed the forest-based fuels used in industry and energy production where you had a very significant increase. The share of black liquor has stayed stable. There has been increase, but it hasn't been as dramatic as on the forest-based fuels. Also, you see the share of wind, solar, and hydropower, where there has been increase, but again, it's been less dramatic than that on the forest-based fuels. And indeed, you can also notice that there's the share of wind is increasing as we go towards 2030. My final slide is on the experiences with the international assessment and review process. So I think it's very important, first of all, to stress that Finland, we've had very positive experiences with the IAR process as a whole. And we note that indeed these reviews, they contribute to the continuous improvement of the reporting. But at the same time, it's important to stress that they are a resource hog. They are resource consuming. And I think for this multilateral assessment, we answered 25 written questions. So it is quite a bit of workload. Perhaps if there were an increased focus on significant issues and on the elements of mandatory reporting that would reduce the burden. It's also very important that the multilateral assessment gives an opportunity to disseminate information, especially on success stories and challenges in implementing policies to reduce emissions. And last but not least, the multilateral assessment indeed allows for dialogue and exchange of experience with other parties, which we consider to be extremely important. Thank you very much for your attention.